Hello friends, in this tutorial we are going to study the Huffman tree visualization. First of all, we will understand what do you mean by Huffman coding. Huffman coding is a lossless data compression algorithm in which a variable length code is assigned to each character given in the input string. It is decided on how frequently the characters are used in the strings. Most frequently the most frequent characters have assigned the smallest codes, whereas the least frequent characters have longer codes. There are mainly two parts in the entire Huffman coding. The first part consists of creation of a Huffman tree, and second part consists of generation of the code for each symbol. That is, we traverse the tree from root node to the leaf node to find the actual code for each and every symbol into the given string. For example, consider a string BBBCAABBBA. The frequency in this string of character B is larger than A, and the character C has the least frequency. So the length of the code for B is always smaller than A, whereas the code for A will be smaller than C. Now we will see the number of steps that we are going to follow in Huffman coding to get the codes for each symbol. The first step is get frequencies. Scan the file that you want to compress and count the number of occurrences of each character. Sort the characters based on their frequencies. Frequency means the number of times the character is appearing into the string. Step 2. Here we build a tree and assign the code to each character. Then how to build the Huffman tree? We follow the following steps to build the Huffman tree. The first step is we select two characters which have smallest frequencies, and we create a new internal node with frequency equal to the sum of two nodes' frequencies. We make first selected node as left child and other node as right child, and at last we add this new node to the symbol table. In second step, we repeat above step till the heap contains only one node, that is the symbol table contains only one node. The remaining node is the root node, and the tree is complete here. After getting the Huffman tree, the next step is to generate the code for each and every symbol into the string. Steps to assign code to each character consist of: first, we label every left edge of the Huffman tree by 0 and every right edge by 1. Then we traverse the tree from root node to the leaf node to assign the code for each symbol. Third step is encoding, where we actually do compressing of the given string. Scan the file again and replace each character by its code. And in last step, we actually do decoding. It is also called as decompress step. We use Huffman tree as the key to decompress the file. Now we'll see one example of designing a Huffman tree and getting the code from it. I am going to use the visualizer program to generate this Huffman tree. You just have to enter the sentence or a string for which you want to generate the Huffman tree. I want to generate a Huffman tree for the word structure. So I will put that word here. STRUCTURE, structure. Okay. Then click on build tree. It will generate the tree for you. So this is the first step. After entering the string, we will first find the character and its frequency. That is the occurrence of each and every character into the string. So if you see here, C is occurring only one time. That's why the frequency for character C is 1. For character E, the frequency is 1. For R, it is 2. For S, it is 1. For T, it is 2. And for U, it is 2. In the next step, we select two minimum frequencies and we generate an internal node. We design a subtree from it. So here we selected these two, node C and node E. Then we merge it to an internal node. So here we add the frequencies of node C and node E, that is 1 plus 1. That's why the frequency for this particular internal node is 2. We can also write the name of this node as CE, 2. Then again we rearrange this node into this symbol table. In the next step, we will again repeatedly apply the previous step. It means again we need to pick the two minimum frequencies and again generate the next internal node. Here we picked this node and node S, which has the minimum frequencies from available frequencies, and we again generate a new node. So we got the new node here with the frequency 3, which is the addition of these two child nodes frequencies 2 plus 1, that is 3. We can also write the name of the node as CES with frequency 3. Again, repeatedly apply the previous steps. To get the next node, we have to again pick the two minimum frequencies, two nodes having minimum frequencies. So we have selected these two. We can select R and T also, because all these three nodes have frequency 2. So we have selected here R2 and U2, and then we merge this. So the total frequency for the internal node will be 4, and the name for this node is RU, 4. In the next step, we will merge node whose frequency is 3 and the next node is T whose frequency is. So these two having the minimum frequencies in the remaining nodes. So 3 and 2 gets merged into the new node. The new node has the frequency 5. And the name of this node is CEST, 5. In the next step, now there are only two nodes available to us, that is 5 and 4. We'll merge these two nodes to get the last node of this tree. We pick this two nodes and we merge it here. So the new node has the frequency 9 and the name of this node is CESTRU with total frequency of 9. So all the nodes are covered. So this is the final Huffman tree. Now we obtained the Huffman tree for the word structure. After getting the Huffman tree, we assign every left edge as 0. It means the left edge is labeled by 0 and the right edge every write is labeled by 1. And suppose if I want to find the Huffman code for the node C, I have to traverse from root node to leaf node, that is C, and we have to collect the label values. So this left edge is labeled by 0, the next left edge is also 0, left edge is also 0. So all are left edges. There are 4 left edges. So the code for node C is 0, 0, 0, 0. For node E, it is 0, 0, 0, and there is a right edge. So it is 1. That's why the code for node E is 0, 0, 0, 1. For node S, it is 0, 0, 1. For node T, it is 0, 1. For node R, it is 1, 0. For node U, it is 1, 1. So these are the Huffman code for each and every symbol in the given string. That is structure which was given to us in the problem. Thank you very much for watching this video.